In this video, we want to talk about how to download and install DataSpell version 2022.2, which is a powerful IDE for Python programming language. It has a lot of capabilities. You can create Jupyter Notebook files and also ordinary Python files. And also the auto-completion and their suggestion is very similar to PyCharm. To my opinion, DataSpell is a combination of PyCharm and the Jupyter Notebook. And again, to my opinion, DataSpell is one of the best IDEs for Python programming language. So in this video, we're going to cover how to download and install DataSpell on Windows for Python programming language. So please stay tuned. So first of all, you should go to google.com and simply type JetBrains DataSpell download. And here's the link from the JetBrains website, which I click on it. And because I have Windows, I simply use this tab. So I have a Windows and I want to download this DataSpell. So I click on it. And now a window like this will be open. You shouldn't do anything. You should wait. And now we can see I can specify the path which I want to download the file. So let's choose this place and press save. And I want to start the download. Now we can see the download has been finished. So I open the containing folder. And here is the installation file. So I right click on it and then click on run as administrator. Then in this window, I press next. And here you should specify a path for installing the DataSpell. So I press next. And if you want to create a desktop shortcut, you can check this one. And also if you want to use this DataSpell for the default software for handling IPython notebook, you can check this. And also if you want to make this DataSpell the default editor for Python files, you can check this, but I don't want to do so. So I uncheck both of them and I press next. And now I press the install button and I should wait for the installation process. Now you can see the installation has been successful, so I want to run the DataSpell, so I check this one and I press the finish button. And it says, do you want to import anything? So because I don't want to import the settings, so I choose this one and I press the OK button. And now a window like this will be opened. So if you have purchased the DataSpell, you can enter your license and etc. But suppose that I want to use the start trial and then I click on this button. Now I can see I can use it for evaluation. So let's press continue. So here you can see that we need Anaconda in order to use in the DataSpell. So we need to install Anaconda as well. And now before going further, I want to download the Anaconda and install that as well because we need it in the DataSpell. So in the Google, I simply type Anaconda download and here is the link. So I open this link from the Anaconda website. And then I should scroll down until you can see these files, which for example, here I have a Windows and I have a 64-bit Windows. So I want to download this. And it should wait for the download. And again, I want to choose a path for downloading the file. And I want to start the download. You can see that the download has been finished. So I open the containing folder. And then I right click on it. And then run this file as administrator. Then I press next. And I press agree. And here again, I press next. And now this is a very, very important step. You should remember this step because the destination folder is very important. So suppose that I want to choose this folder as the installation folder. And remember that you should copy this path because we need it later in this video. So copy this path and remember the install location and then press next. And now again, I press the install button. And now I should wait for the installation process. So as you can see, the installation has been completed. So I press next and then again, I press next and I want to uncheck both of these. So I press finish and then I want to go to the install location, which I have told you to copy the install location. And remember that for the DataSpell, we need two files. The first file is this file, python.exe. And remember that if you don't see these extensions, you should go to View and check File Name Extensions. So remember to check File Name Extensions. And after checking the File Name Extensions, you can see that this is python.exe, which is the Python interpreter. This is the first thing that you should note. And the other one, the other file that you should notice is inside this folder, scripts. So if I open it, if I scroll down, you can see that there is a file called conda.exe, which is another important file which we needed later in the DataSpell. So as I have told you in this video, when I was installing the Anaconda, you should notice two files. First, the conda.exe, and the other one is python.exe, which is the Python interpreter. So first of all, let's define the location of our python.exe, our Python interpreter. So let's click on this three dots. So it is in my C drive, in users, kulak, in Python folder, and in Anaconda 3.9 folder. And you can see python.exe. And the other file is our conda file. So again, I click on this. So again, I choose C drive, users, kulak, the Python folder, and Anaconda 3.9. And in a scripts folder, we have this file, conda.exe. So I click on it and I press OK. And now I press launch DataSpell. And I should wait. So let's close the tour. And I should wait for the indexing process and all the stuff here. And as you can see, a prompt like this will be shown. So you can, if you want, you can press don't show again, but I want to exclude directories from the Windows Defender. So I click configure automatically. And remember, I should wait for these processes. So you can see these processes have been finished. So let's maximize this window. And now let's create a project. So I click on this file. I want to create new workspace directory. Then I should specify a name for my project. Let's call that YouTube. And remember that the path of this project is this, so we can copy it because we need it later in this video. So remember to copy this path. Then I click on create button, and again I should wait for these processes. And now in order to create a Python file, I right click on this, and I want to create a new Python file. So for example, let's call it code01, and I press enter. And now here we can see that we have a Python file which we can write whatever we want. So let's print something, let's print 5 times 9. So in order to run this code, right click and then press run code01, which is the name of our code. And here you can see here is the result, and you can see that it works properly. And also let's create a Jupyter Notebook file. So I right click on this. I want to create a new Jupyter Notebook. So I click on this. And for example, I want to call it notebook01. And I press enter. And you can see here is our Jupyter Notebook environment, which we can start coding. And also, if you want to change the theme of our DataSpell, you can simply do that. You can go to File, then Settings, then in the Appearance tab, and in the Appearance section, you can change the theme to, for example, let's say Windows 10 Lite. And if I press OK, you can see here's the theme. And now I can type whatever I want. So for example, let's define a text. So this is a test from DataSpell. Now I want to print something. I want to print, let's say, 5 times 9. And I press Control Enter to run this cell. And you can see here is the result. Now, if I go to the path which I have told you to copy, which is, for example, for me, it is C users kulak DataSpell projects. And if I open it, you can see that I have different projects. One of them is called YouTube, which is the one that we have created just now. So let's open it. And you can see here we have a code 01 Python file. And also we have notebook 01 IPython notebook, which is the Jupyter notebook. So you can see these are our files which we have just created. But if you want to learn more about this Jupyter notebook environment in DataSpell, you can watch the next video. So don't forget to subscribe and click the bell next to it to be notified of every new video. Thank you for watching.